Hello there, Pisces. Welcome into the channel. This is Sage, Sensei Healing Tarot. Thank you for being here. I do hope you are doing well in this time, Pisces. We're going to get some general messages for the sun, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign. Alright, so because it's general messages, all of the messages may not apply to all of you. So take the ones that do apply and the rest let them apply. Thank you for being here. Ooh, Pisces. What's this? Someone, old soulmate, old love. This is the energy of Pisces, the King of Cups, right? Water sign. So this card is saying the one that loves you, Pisces. This could be talking about a fellow water sign, or this is you. I feel like there's something to celebrate coming up. Maybe someone is moving to their love, relocating or going back home or something. Okay, maybe someone is getting vacation and going home. All right, so let's take the tarot and get some messages for you from the tarot. Messages for Pisces for their week. Oh my God, look, the Six of Cups once more that we just saw. We just saw it here, the Six of Hearts. So it's connecting with that old soulmate or a familiar friend. Or this is someone absolutely new that is really just resonating on the same vibration as you. This person can be what? Fire, Leo vibration with the sun energy. Or any other fire sign, Sagittarius, Aries. This person has a very vibrant, fun, outgoing spirit. I feel very, very beautiful and attractive as well. Their approach to life is just free expression, full expression, a lot of energy. It's almost like someone may be coming into you, Pisces, to make an offering or to offer something or to pledge love or just wants to align with you, like wants to align, ally, or maybe wants to be your ally, your friend, your partner in work. Maybe you're going to meet up with this person. It's like going on a break, on a vacation, but to meet with a business potential or romantic and talk about future plans and so on and so forth. So Pisces, who is the Six of Cups? Oh, maybe someone that just left a previous marriage, or yeah, because this person is deciding to change, a change in their world. I've been seeing the Five of Swords since I started shuffling for you, Pisces. It just feels like letting go of certain connections. I feel like maybe it was a tough fight, like it really took a lot of focus and attention. You know, but someone is maybe finally free, you know what I mean? Like it's finally over. Maybe it was something in court. And so this person now has the freedom to choose where they're going to go next. Fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Someone is definitely moving toward you. Could also be Aquarius, Gemini, Libra, air sign. Or it's just the action that is taken toward you. Maybe someone is taking action to come toward you. Right. Something has ended. A relationship. Possibly with an earth sign. Possibly someone was doing something behind someone else's back. I feel like someone has also been working on themselves internally. And, you know, making some money, of course, as well. And perfecting their craft, so on and so forth. We're going to look at the Tower card because something ended, Pisces. Let's look at the Tower. What is the Tower? Pisces, what ended? Look, the Hangman came out. This is your vibration, Pisces. So it's like maybe you moved on from a relationship with someone else, like it's finally over. Or something that has been pending is coming through for you. And I hear the word victory. Success. I did see the Three of Cups vibration earlier. So you're going to be successful. It's like you're making a decision, as you may be traveling across the world to do something, but you're not 150% sure how it will work out. But I'm telling you, it will. It's like that little bit of faith that you need to move forward. Maybe it was a business connection that ended, or a fling or something like that. Something that wasn't, or it could have been a marriage for real. So someone can move toward their real soulmate or their desires. Maybe someone was thinking too much, or, you know, as I said, procrastination, delays, putting things off, waiting. So that's ended, Pisces. So what is the Hangman vibration? The Devil. All right, so it's definitely something that's what ended for you. Is something toxic, I feel, and it could be procrastination or habits or thoughts or feelings. It feels like it could have been feelings that you were dwelling on in your mind. You weren't clear really, but now it's over. Maybe you got some clarity with the Ace of Swords. I like, when I see the Sun and the Devil, whoa, that's powerful. There's a lot of spiritual things going on around you. But the thing is, you have this sword. You have the word, maybe prayer, speech. You know what I mean? As if you decided to come out against this toxicity, this devil vibration, to end it, whatever it was for you. What is the Devil? Strength, Leo energy, once more, as if maybe you were afraid of this Leo, of this strength energy, you weren't showing your strength, as if you, it's almost like you wanted to talk to someone or to approach someone else, but the energy surround, as if you were just really afraid because of your own feelings or issues, maybe self-worth, and all of that. So maybe that's why you went to work on yourself. Like I said, did internal work. And now I feel you're coming back. King of Cups present. Like you're saying, I'm ready. I'm ready for love. I'm ready to move forward. I'm ready to face my fears. I'm ready to speak some truth. I'm ready for clarity. I'm ready to move out of this old rut I've been in here. I'm ready to really just move forward. It's like you were in tar or grease or muck or mud. You weren't suffering and you weren't adopting, but it's almost like you were there, like feeling it out. You know what I mean? And you're so very super powerful. I'm getting the energy of someone who is so powerful, like they could go in hell and sit there and talk to the entities or whatever in hell, like to clear your mind, like you're wondering, so why do I do this? And you're walking around back and forth in this dark space. I feel like that's what you were doing with the Hangman vibration here. You know, trying to figure out what to do. It's like you dived into your own dark world or something to figure out what was keeping you from what. Breaking some spell or chain or barrier, especially having to do with your emotions. Something was preventing you from taking the action that you needed to take, Pisces. And you went to figure it out. Like, it was literally an energy in you that was feeling stuck. Because you felt like you wanted to do something, but you didn't have enough drive or willpower to do so. So that's where the Swords vibration comes in, which is willpower. It's in your hand. You know, you call the shots. The Ace of Swords is my Christ consciousness energy. Like, higher wisdom, higher intelligence, and even deeper insights. Christ consciousness, like you've been chosen, the crowned one. So yeah, I do feel like you have what it takes to go into this dark world where we would call the devil. Because we do have the Sun. I feel you definitely could be very chosen, Pisces. Spiritually gifted, connected to your ancestors. But there's a change that you're making, a shift. A swift. Could be a swift shift. you know, to denounce this. It's like you found the answer that you were looking for all of a sudden while you were in this dark place in hell or wherever your devil tendencies lay, you know. And you found the answers and you're like, answer or answers. And you're like, oh my God, got it. And as soon as you got it, you made a decision and it ended things. As if you knew why, you found out why you weren't moving forward. So yeah, you fixed that. And then you went and approached this love, fellow water sign, or earth or fire. And I see strong fire Leo energy here. Okay. What else? Oh, we wanted to look at the sword. What is a sword? I feel like it's something you're going to say. Empress. Sword. Oh my gosh. I was hoping to see the Page of Cups because I know it's something you're going to say. It's something you're going to say. The Page of Cups is, say, I have something to say. That's what it is in this deck. The Lovers. What is the Page of Cups? Oh my goodness. Do you see this? It came. I want to clarify the Page of Cups. I have something to say. Something that's literally on your mind, on your tongue, maybe wanting to have happiness with this person. See what I mean? You're approaching this one here. Could be you or another person, but I do feel it's you. Water sign energy. Going to speak. What are you going to say? I have so the Jack of Cups repeated. It says, you know, say something. I want, I long, I hope. It is my wish to achieve you. Maybe you're talking to an Empress. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Or fire sign, honestly. The Empress, I feel, embodies all of the elements. The least is air for me with the Empress vibration. But definitely air. Because she's very thoughtful. Excuse me. And composed. So we're going to see. What do you have to say? Forgive me. Alright, Pisces. Still what? You're still not saying anything? I'm not sure if someone betrayed someone or left them alone. Someone felt lonely, hurt. The Emperor, Earth sign, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Maybe something about work or building, or as if you have built something. Or released or confirmed. The Wheel of Fortune, the Queen of Cups. So I think you could want to Pisces, like maybe fall in love with someone. Maybe you recognize something in this person. I don't know why. It feels like they turned their back on you-ish. You feel like with the Wheel of Fortune, it feels like you feel like you're, you know, this is your north energy. I don't know. Like you're going with your heart. Yes, I don't know, maybe if you've met this person before, maybe at work, on a platform, on a stage, while you were working, I don't know how this person was treated, or this could be you that was treated away by your this person, this Queen of Cups, or fire sign, or Leo. But it's like, I feel like you feel this person is your work, like your, I can't really explain it. You know what I mean? It's like everything. With the Wheel of Fortune, it feels like everything. Like maybe you've lived many different lifetimes with this one. Like you feel like you would recognize this person from Egypt and from Rome and wherever else. Norway. I don't know. Maybe not Norway, but some different. Like Egypt, for real. Like you feel like you'd recognize this one. And maybe you want to say you've released something from your past. You're not entertaining some things anymore. Okay. There could be someone blocking this connection. It could be you or this person that's blocking you. As if you got lucky all of a sudden. Like all of a sudden, maybe you won something. Look. Or maybe you feel lucky. The star. You know, I feel like you feel lucky, Pisces, because I feel like you were able to walk away from something that wasn't serving you. It caused you some pain and strain and all these things. Maybe chaos in your emotions, your family. But you decided to follow your heart on this journey. All right, leaving these messages here, hit the like button, share, subscribe, comment. All of your support is appreciated. You support by doing any one of the actions I said earlier, by liking the video, sharing the messages, hit share and share in your groups, on your blogs, etc. And also, I'd love it if you become a subscriber here if you're not already a subscriber. So hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you in the next one. Remember that you're all and all is within you, Pisces. Take care. Bye.